Welcome gamers everywhere, this is htaed7 bringing you another live stream once again. I hope you guys are doing excellent today. As you can see by the new format that I'm going to be starting today, I mean nothing much is going to change visually, but basically I'm going to be doing two shorter streams instead of one long one. I have my own personal reasons to try this out, since most of these streams go back to YouTube once I've done doing the stream, I want to see, or I want to test out to see if this will, in some way affect the views, because I'm guessing, it's my guess, and I'm thinking that it might be yours as well, that people on YouTube don't tend to go for the really long videos. So I'm trying to divide them into chunks to see if this way I can help, you know, boost up the views a bit. But nothing is going to change, at least on this side, only that it's going to be like stream for an hour, 45 minutes or an hour, and then go take a break and then come back and so on and so forth. If the need arises for me to have to make more of them, I will make more of them, you know. Or if in any case the stream merits that it should be one long one, like the playthroughs, then I will do that. But without further ado, let's start with the Neo Geo Brawlers for today. Let's go here into the main screen and let's cut this out. Okay. Now I asked if you guys wanted for me to start off with either Mutation Nation or Burning Fight, and apparently Burning Fight ended up being the one, so I'm gonna do that. Eventually I'm gonna cover, I'm gonna try to cover most of them. Bring the sound a bit higher. There you go. That should serve well enough. So yeah, let's do Burning Fight. This, well, as you can see by the intro and it's not trying to avoid being Final Fight. This is basically Final Fight, and the naming conventions tend to make you think that there's a little bit of a Double Dragon influence in there as well. Okay, got basic attack, jump, some kick. Alright. Wonder if it has any dash. Oh! Let me pick up this nice little wine bottle. Aha! Wonder if it has a special move. My pressing several buttons. Yeah, there it goes. And it's, in this case, in this guy's case, it's kind of like a hurricane kick type move. And if at this point you don't know what a hurricane kick is, then I don't know what to say. So far, wait, what's this time thing? Okay. So yeah, there's nothing truly different from this one besides of being sort of like a Final Fight clone. But I really don't see it bringing like anything new to the table like we've encountered with past beat-em-ups. But that's not to say that it's a bad game, because it's not. It plays really well. Oh, damn. That was cold, man. Really? And I can't escape from that. What about your special move, man? Where's your special move when you need it? Okay, let's try the double dragon dude, Billy. I'm guessing this is the big guy. Yep. Take the gun. Ah, that's a nice little touch. Oh, jump, dude, jump. Seriously. Okay, so you literally need to break the truck they're riding. That's nice. Okay. Big belly dude comes in and takes away. Oh, those rolling moves. I hate them. I'm guessing that dash is his special move. Yeah. It would be nice if it had some kind of block button, which I'm not entirely sure if it has, but it would be nice, kind of like the Batman one that I played. Considering the suckage, I think this is going to be the last credit I try. And hop on to the next game. Oh shit, Dragon Punch. Thank you. shit. Ah, okay. I see. And, okay, no, I thought that that wasn't gonna cost me for my life, but no, I was wrong. It does take away some of the energy that you have. Okay, let's bust up the store and steal the money. Dragon punch type uppercut is pretty cool, but it doesn't really have that much reach. The arc is upward, and you have to be like really, really close in order for it to be effective. Taking into consideration that most of the games at the time when this game came out were basically much more smaller sprites because of the 8 and 16-bit graphics at the time. So playing this is like riding a Porsche, or at least that's how it was back in the day. Some loot. Corn dog. Take this little corn dog. Get your energy back. Smack him around with it. There you go. But somehow, I don't know, is it me? I somehow expected at least to see some blood on this, given that they, SNK never really was shy to be showing blood in their games. Here I got a fight with somebody who looks like a cross between Hulk Hogan and Macho Randy Savage. Oh, you can! I'm betting that's a clothesline. That's it. That's burning fight. Now, coming up next, let's see, what can we, hell, why not? I mean, the other one that I mentioned, where I asked if you guys wanted to see first, was Mutation Nation. So let's go with that one now. Glitchy corner there. Oh, yeah. Okay. has colored life bars, and the action seems to be a bit more intense. Same basic attack. We got the jump button. Oh, you can press and charge with this one for the special. Nice. So you can choose what kind of special you got. That means that the rest of the buttons are not used at all. Holy crap, what was that? All of the special moves need to be charged. They're also limited, so you cannot spam them. Graphics on this one seems to be a much improved from Burning Fight. Really colorful and very detailed. With that mega fireball. I want to try another one. Energy. Need a lot of that. What? Oh, so now I get it. That's why it's called Mutation Nation. Because people are turning into mutants. Or something along those lines. But I only got one kind. I want to try something else. I'd like to try the thunder one. Hey, bad luck. You been there for a while? I just looked over to the chat. I wasn't seeing much movement, so I just noticed. Today I start doing what I said I was gonna do, where I'm gonna have just two, for the time being, two short streams, about 45 minutes to an hour each. So I'll be here till 7 o'clock and then take a break until 8, and then at 8 I'll start streaming again. Difficulty on this one is really not that bad. Now I want to try this special. What? Just teleport? What the hell was that? Oh, I see. Oh, easy there, easy there. Well, everything is set for Thursday and the Silent Hill 3 stream, which I'll be doing for the next 3 days, starting on Thursday until Halloween night. Let's see how we do with that. It's been the longest time since I played Silent Hill 3, so let's see if I don't get creamed. Okay, let's charge it up. What? It didn't do anything. You crafty little son of a bitch. Nice. Damn, nasty right hook. Ah, it doesn't give you the choice to pick another character. Right, no problem. I would like to take this moment to give a shout out to Olivia Rodriguez, one of the newest followers on Twitter. All I can say is, you know, follow your dreams and don't let anything or anybody stop you. If you feel a passion for something, just go ahead. We got too many things trying to bring us down. And very few that are, you know, uplifting and positive. So we gotta, like, once we find that positive thing, just embrace it and not let it go. I try my best doing that, but sometimes it's really hard. Especially when there's a lot of people out there that just wanna bring the bad out of you. Just like these mutants are trying to bring the worst out of me. And I have to kick their asses. Ooh, gotta get energy. There we go. Can't get cornered. No, no. Oh. Aha. Got you. They are literally blowing their lids off. I'm trying to understand the motif on this, because they're mutants, but why do they turn into insects? I'm trying to make sense out of a story in a beat 'em up. Go figure. Oh, nasty little bugger. Yeah, I think I should go pick another one. I know there are a few good ones. One that basically, in many ways, doesn't feel like a beat-em-up, however, I kind of think it is. It's the next one I'm gonna put. I'm gonna play. Is, I think I just passed by it. This one right here. I know many people are not gonna see this one as a beat-em-up. I consider it a beat-em-up because more than many other games, you really depend a lot on the melee aspect of it. Top Hunter. You do have guns and you do have a few other mechanics, but you basically depend on your punches. So yeah. This one here, I'm a little partial to the game too because it's a really fun game. Let me get this glitchy thing out of the way. There we go. Basic hit, pressing down, stretch and grab. That's the tricky part, remembering how to move from plane to plane. I think is the most, let's try ice, eh? Weird stage to start out on, but oh shit. And I forget that this is time based as well, so. Here we go, bonus game. Let's go. Ah! I missed the power! Oh. No! Ah! Oh my god. I'm sucking so bad. There we go. I can't go over to this anymore. Oh shit, I messed up. No. Wait. Now I get in. Open. Crap. Ah, hurry up! That was shitty. This game is owning me so bad. And again, open up! Jesus. Okay, I can't let it fool me again. Gotta wait. Be patient. Hey. Turn around! Head. Can I kill it? No, I guess not. I smack him around. Time! Yes, I can use that. What? hits. Halfway to the boss. Talking. Got some mega action going on now. Whoa! No, 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 gonna break my. Dude, I got a feeling I'm gonna need this. Damn, that didn't last long at all. This one is Top Hunter. Okay, I'll grab something to shoot you with. Don't worry. Unfortunately, that killed me. Oh shit, wasn't expecting that. So now I gotta fight this other crabby thing. Jesus, all I keep getting is whacked and shit. I'll be done here, Afros, I'll be done here in about 15-20 minutes, because I'll stop at 7 and then start back on at 8. Okay, I need that time. Good. There's a little timing that's involved in grabbing the enemies and stuff, but it's pretty cool. At least it breaks up the monotony of, you know, just punching and kicking and doing regular stuff. That's why I wanted to include this one, because even though it's not technically a beat-em-up, it does use the same mechanics as a beat-em-up. That's in a different way. Power, yes. Golden. chocolate. I did not notice that he was carrying a fucking door. Okay. Okay. Not even close to the boss yet. At least, at the very least, the shadow helps out a little bit. Oh, so I gotta grab the parts. That's simple enough. Let's see you fly without that shit. Hold the lever. Super time. Bitch. Jeez, I thought it was... You do get kind of confused with the foreground and background sometimes when stuff is coming towards you. But it's still an awesome game though. This one is Top Hunter. This one is for a Neo Geo. I just wanted it to feature it in assertive aggression because, like I mentioned before, it's not a beat 'em up in the traditional sense of the word, but it does share some of its mechanics, so. Take his weapon away and use it. Maybe I can use... Oh shit, I can't use the mecha. I guess I cornered him. Too much. No! There you go. At least the bombs can hurt him too, which is good. That is that a one-hit thing? Really, teleport. And he shoots also, nice. I'm guessing the best way to get him is simply jumping on top of his head and then quickly afterwards hitting him. Because he blocks that shit too. And you can get hit by the uppercut as well. Remember you guys, Thursday starts Silent Hill 3. places. Isn't it good enough to just simply dodge the boulder? No. Try golden. Golden, baby. What happened there? Ah! I lost my power. Why? Jesus, die already, what the fuck? Yeah, no prize there. Oh, the time was on the other side. See? It gets pretty confusing. Alright, super time. Bonus stage. Next one up is going to be one from the Sengoku series. Which a lot of people are torn between liking the second, either the second or the third one, but nobody's really partial to the first one for some reason. Everywhere that I ask is always the same thing. It's either a toss-up between the second one or the third one. In terms of being, you know, favorite. And I wanna see what's up with this. Are you kidding me? I just missed it. Some hidden time and a power. Nice. No! Move. What? You kidding me?
What?
Okay, that's gonna be all for Chop Hunter. Now, let's see. For the last game of this second part, I think we can play some. I think the second part is mostly gonna be Sengoku, because we got Sengoku and we got Robo Army. Because there are not many. Let's do the first part of Sengoku now, and then I'll continue with the second part after I come from the break. There it is. First one, you get an idea. Second one looks a lot like the first one. It is the third one that visually changes a lot. So we're gonna start with this one. This. I'm gonna try here. This one in 1991. Oh, wait. Oh, what did I do? There it is. Okay. Basic attack, basic jump. Swords, I'm gonna start. Nice. Okay. And this already started. Nice. Kind of reminds me a little bit of Ninja Spirit. Holy crap! Just out of nowhere, a fucking skull just started spitting. Oh my god, I'll give you a hand. Okay. Please do. Hey, nice billboard. Shit, he's like Fist of the North Star. He has like some fucking. Give me the green! Give me the green ball! What I don't seem to be doing right is to change. was said in the beginning that if you press the button, you can change from power to power. I don't know. I guess it just picks it depending on the one you get and the color. See, it just changes automatically. You don't have any say in the matter. Does look pretty awesome though. I don't know why would people complain about this game? This seems to be a lot more fun than Burning Fight, I can tell you that. I'm gonna try one more credit before I go take a break. I'll be right back shortly. Okay, now I can change. But change to what? Oh shit, this is nice. And I changed, and I got my ass kicked. Oh my god. Now I gotta kick this guy's ass. Jesus. Well, what the hell. Let's leave it here. Might as well let's leave it here. And I'll come back at 8 o'clock to feature Sengoku 2, 3, and Robo Army. Which I will conclude the scene of Assertive Aggression featuring the Neo Geo beat-em-ups or brawlers. So I will be right back. Don't go anywhere.